Hi friends, thank you for selecting this video. This video particularly prepared for beginners, those who are interested to learn Telly.
Friends, if you don't have Telly software, you can go to Google and type tallysolutions.com, and there you can download Telly software. If you have already having the Telly software, you can ignore this session, this section. Okay, after going to that site, you can see one download button on the top. Simply click on downloads. Then browse down the page. Wait for a moment. There you can see one install now and download later. You can choose any one of these options. After that, you go and click on Telly icon. It is opening. After opening, simply select work in educational mode and click. Here I am choosing my data location /tally ERP9/data. I think it is not necessary in your computer. Okay, now let's start. How to create a company? Click on create a company. Here enter your company name. Okay, Raj Enterprises. Then you can type the address of your company here. Then country, select the country, then state. Okay, you can fill phone number, pin code, whatever you wish. Then here financial start from. If you wish to start from 1/4/2018, type here 1/4/2018. If you are willing to start from 1/4/2019, you can start 1/4/2019. Books begin from also, that is the same date. Now go to accounting vouchers. Now I am going to enter a purchase voucher. Here you can enter the invoice number of your client, then date. Here the name of party, supplier. Here I am going to create a new one. Neeraj Enterprises, under group sundry creditors. Here you can type the address of your supplier. That's it. Here enter the purchase invoice value. In this demo I am not going to explain about the inventory and all. Simply I am showing the demo how to record purchase voucher without in inventory and taxes. Purchase ledger you have to create under group purchase account, that is main. So this purchase entry is over. You can put a narration being purchased goods from Niraj Enterprises, like that. After finishing of this, I am going to enter one payment voucher. Click on payment, date 1-2. Click the date 1-2. Because we have purchased, so that we are paying the amount to that Niraj. Here I am going to pay through bank. I am going to create one ledger, State Bank of India. While creating bank ledger, it should come under bank accounts. Please note this point. That's it. Here enter Niraj Enterprises. Here I am paying 3000. It's a part payment being amount paid to Niraj Enterprises. That's it. So this is payment, is the payment voucher is over. Now I am going to enter one sale voucher. Now just check out the ledger balance, how it shows. Ledger Niraj Enterprises. This ledger, it is showing 2000. Credit balance, that means we have purchased goods from him 5000 and paid 3000, and balance amount 3000 we have to pay to that supplier Niraj Enterprises. That's fine. Now I'm going to enter one more entry, that is sale voucher. Here I want to create one ledger, that is a customer ledger. Alt C, I put Alt C to create the customer ledger. Raman Engineering, under groups, sundry debtors. Please note down, customer will come sundry debtors, supplier will come under sundry creditors. And whatever the office expenses comes under indirect expenses. Okay, after finishing that, here I don't want to enter inventory, that is stock items, so that as click on as voucher, here Raman Engineering, I am billing for 10,000 credit to sales account. Sales, sales ledger is there, that is why you have to create. Press Alt C to create sales account under group sales account. Please note that sales comes under sales accounts, purchase comes under purchase accounts. Being goods sold to Raman Engineering, 12,000. Okay. Now, after finishing this, I am going to enter receipt voucher, because after bill rising, they will give payment. That is, I am going to enter in receipt voucher. Receipt. Say bank. If they given check, you have to enter bank account. If they give cash, you have to enter cash an account field. Say enter paying amount received from Raman Engineering. Support payment received from him by check. Okay, that's fine. And now go to ledger trial balance. We can see the trial balance. What are the ledgers? Is here. First one is Neeraj Enterprises, that is 5000 purchase and 3000 payment, and balance is 2000. And this is purchase account, 5000 is the purchase value. Then Raman Engineering, in this account we have sold goods to 10,000 and received payment 7,000. The balance is 3,000. Is yet to receive from Raman Engineering. Then next, sales account. Recently we billed to Raman Engineering 10,000. That is the credit. Bank ledger. 7,000 received and 3,000 paid. 4,000 is available in at State Bank of India. Next, I am going to withdraw cash from State Bank, already having 4,000. So that I am going to withdraw 2,000. Go to accounting voucher. Click on contra. Here I am entering cash because cash withdrawing from bank. State Bank of India 2000. While you are withdrawing cash, enter cash on top, bottom bank account. If you deposit, enter bank account on the top. And in particular, enter cash. That is the thing. Okay. That's over. Now I am going to show the demo for journal entry. Accounting voucher F7. Payment. One second. Oh, I am making payment for mobile recharge through cash. Under indicators, please note that whatever the expenses related to office, rent, salaries, mobile bill, internet, whatever it is, that comes under indirect expenses. 1,000 rupees being paid amount for mobile recharge for 2 employees each 500. Okay. This is already I captured this video. After that I am adding the voice. That is why it is having some difficulty. Payment, cash payment is over. Now I want to show journal in next screen. Please wait. Go to accounting voucher. Click F7. Here I am going to book a salary for month of January, because this January salary we pay in February. That is why in month end I have to put on journal voucher, so that we can book a salary on that date. Here debit is salary account, that undercomes under group indirect expense, and credit to outstanding expenses. Outstanding expense is a liability, current liability. So here debit, under debit I am going to create one salary account. There is no salary account as so far, so I am pressing Alt C to create this salary account. That comes under indirect expense. Salary account 30,000. Credit to salary outstanding. The ledger is not found, so that I am going to create by press Alt C. Salary outstanding. It comes under current liabilities. That's it. Being salary payable . Thank you for watching this. Please like this video and subscribe this video, so that you will get further upload new videos, and also share with your friends. One more payment, State Bank of India, salary account. So in February I am going to release salary. Say amount is 2000. That is you have to debit to salary outstanding account. Okay. Being salary paid 2000 through bank. That's it. For beginners, these are the very important topics. If you thorough in this, you can go for another advanced syllabus like inventory, GST, etc. So if you want more lessons on my videos, you can subscribe and share the videos with your friends, so that you can indirectly support to our channel. Please like it. Okay, bye. Thank you for watching.